Welcome to a new reading vlog. Hi guys, so today is Monday and I have been feeling really good since yesterday because I finished a book that I really liked, Cross Her Heart, and it kind of makes me want to read more. It wasn't like a 5-star read, but it was definitely a 4-star read that was really good and I want to read more. So I picked up this book, The Mogul by Vish Dhamija. Vish Dhamija is one of the most popular Indian thriller writers and he's one of the few legal thriller writers. So if you are into legal dramas or courtroom dramas, you might check out Vish Dhamija books. I have read one book by the author and I liked it so much, so I ended up getting this one for myself. So I'm just flipping through the pages, not really keen on reading it, just flipping through these pages, and if I like it, maybe I'll continue reading it this week. If you're watching me for the first time, I make book related videos on this channel every Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday, and this is a new reading vlog which is an attempt to read and talk about reading through my reading slump. So it's happening, it's still there. I'm actually reading a book that I'm really not liking. I would not talk about it right now, but apart from that, it's just hasn't been good. I am in a reading slump. A lot of people ask me, Manpreet, how do you get out of a reading slump, or how are you reading when you have a reading slump? You do not read a book that is giving you or making you go into a reading slump. And you pick up a book that you're really liking, so you have to really just have a pile of books on the side and try out different books and see if anything gets you interested. I am planning to spend some time with this book, The Mogul by Vish Dhamija. It's a legal thriller. Okay guys, so let me tell you about this book. So this is a legal thriller. So basically there is this mogul, there is this business tycoon named Prem, and he has lived a very nice life, and you know, he is a highly respected and highly recognized individual of the society. And now suddenly his ex-wife dies and her husband also dies, and Mr. Prem Bedi is being considered as a suspect. Most likely somebody is trying to pin this murder on him, but we don't know it yet. I have my theories. You know, when you start reading such a book, you have your theories. My theory says that I already know the person who has done it is already introduced in the story, but mostly when you read a whodunit, they never introduce the person who has done it right in the beginning. Sometimes they do, because one of my favorites in that, the person is there right from the beginning and you just do not understand that this person has been there, the murderer has been there right from the beginning in the forefront. And do not ask me about that book, because if I tell you about it, it will be a spoiler. Just watch all of my videos to figure out which are my favorite, you know, crime mystery novels. This is more sort of a legal thriller, and there is also this brother-in-law of his ex-wife who is trying to pin it, who is trying to just ruin the reputation of Prem Bedi and trying to pin the murder on him, trying to tell the world that he is the murderer. I have been really excited about reading this book. Trust me, first of all, I should be working. Secondly, I should be reading another book that is there for me for review, which I got paid for. But I just could not get myself into that book because I'm so much interested in this book. This is good. This is good. That one is okay. This is awesome. Happy with it. I have read about... Now, I started reading it today. I thought I'll read a chapter and then I'll get to my work and then I'll get to that book. At that time, I was on page number 15. What am I doing right now? I am on page number 82 of The Mogul. Guys, I am on page number 154 of The Mogul. I'm really liking this book. So right now I'm thinking there could be three possibilities of who did the murders. I think number one can be like the mogul himself can be guilty. He has been shown as not guilty and he has been shown as a person who cannot commit this murder. But what if he has really done it? Or I think it could be the business partner. So there is a brief meeting, there is a brief game that happens in the beginning for a business partnership, and these people are not from India and they cannot even speak the Indian language. But what if these people, because you would not really think that these people could be the ones who are just planning this whole thing out and putting the whole blame and framing Mr. Bedi. This could be one other reason. Or I think right now when I'm saying it, I think there is Mr. Bedi's friend who is an advocate and a friend, and the case of Mr. Bedi is also being fought by Rohan, Mr. Bedi's friend's son.
So I'm thinking, what if the friend did it? That could also be possible. And I'm also thinking maybe somebody wants him to go down and somebody wants to take over his business, like somebody from the board of directors. But that is also not very convincing, I would say, because there is little attention on what is happening to his business. Yes, there is a lot of talk about his reputation going down because of this whole thing, because of this whole drama, especially when media is making such a big thing out of it. But there is not much attention there. But who knows who did it? I'm just reading it just now. The court drama has begun, like the trial has begun, and I'm just like really happy about it. I have been reading The Mogul by Vish Dhamija non-stop. There was a courtroom drama and everything was amazing. Okay, just the end, I think. And I just feel like the person, I guess, was the one who did this, is the one who did this. Like the biggest suspect in my mind was this person. And I was just like 80% sure this would be it. Otherwise, there were three other entities that could have done it. I'm pretty sure the one I suspected the most did it. And it would be amazing because I feel like this person just slipped away the detail of why, the motive. This person just slipped away the motive. Wow, this is a really good book. I feel like the whole book, I haven't read many courtroom dramas anyway. I have seen a lot of courtroom dramas, Good Wife, Suits, How to Get Away with Murder, and likewise. But I have never read many courtroom dramas. I have read a few. I have read Unlawful Justice by the same author, Vish Dhamija. And it was decent. It was really good, but just like 4 out of 5. And I feel like after I finish this, this could be 4.5 out of 5. So excited! I'm so happy I read this, okay? This person just gave away the motive and nobody guessed it in the entire book. Even when everybody was so this close to knowing the motive, nobody guessed it. It's genius. It's genius. It's just like you're so close to something and you're still so far from it, okay? It's just like, it's like there is a murder movie going on and the murderer with a knife in his hand is standing right in front of you. And somehow there is this glass mirror, so the murderer can see you, but you can see only yourself, not the murderer. But this person is this close to you. It's amazing. I will update you more about it next day, because once I'm done with this book, I'm not talking to anybody. I'm just going to revel in the happiness that I'll get from this book. Oh my god. I finished reading Vish Dhamija's book and it was fantastic. It was really fantastic. I really loved it. Now I picked up another legal thriller. I'm just flipping through the pages. I'm not sure if I will read it or continue reading it, but I have just read 15 pages of The Whistler by John Grisham. Basically, these are the books that I have had for a long time and I'm just working on going through these books, reading these books so that I can just get through my TBR. I don't know how many of you actually saw the vlog in which I discussed about the goal of just getting through my TBR, and I have officially like finished 5 books from my existing TBR. Number one I finished reading was Telltale, then The Boy with the Striped Pajamas, then The Secrets We Keep by Sudeep Nagarkar, then The Crosser Heart, and now I just finished reading The Mogul by Vish Dhamija.
Hi guys, this is Manpreet from the future, and this was a reading vlog where I read The Mogul by Vish Dhamija. Let me just wrap it up and tell you what were my feelings while I was reading this book. I'll try my best not to give away any spoilers, okay? So this story begins with this game. Vish Dhamija's Prem Bedi is a business tycoon. He is very respected in the community and almost everybody knows him. He's like a celebrity in the business world. And the book begins when Prem Bedi with his friend is playing a game, okay? He is having this business meeting where they are playing a game with this person of some other country who cannot even speak their language. They have to use a translator for this, okay? And suddenly the friend gets a call, and the friend gets a call about how his ex-wife has been murdered and her husband is also murdered. Slowly, slowly the things unfold. There is talk of what happened to them, how they were murdered, with what weapon they were murdered, and what were the clues that were found on the scene. And meanwhile, the brother-in-law of this ex-wife is trying to tarnish the reputation of Prem Bedi. He is just saying that there couldn't be anybody else who had the motive to kill his brother and his sister-in-law. And obviously, the investigation begins, then the court case, everything happens. As you continue reading this book, you have questions about the murder weapon, you have questions about the motive, you have questions about whether Prem Bedi could be the one who actually did it. It's just a very nice process to read this book and see the steps unfold one by one, what happens. And there is another person who comes into the scene, who is a person who is just starting out in his career as an advocate, Rohan, and what he does. And I feel like as a character, Rohan was very smart. He was just like a, he was just like an underdog for me, really. He realizes this could be a big opportunity, and he's not just like, okay, you know, I don't care. He is really much into this opportunity. He really wants to make this happen. He really wants to give it his best shot. And, you know, just the emotions Rohan goes through while he gets hold of this big opportunity, that is also amazing. The emotions you go through, because you are always wondering who did it, who could have done it. And, you know, one by one, the things come out, and you also feel like, sometimes you feel like, oh my God, why is this happening? Because this person, the brother-in-law, he is just such a publicity hungry person and so clever. And you're like, okay, the characters, all of those, there is a police investigator who comes up, and there are other small characters who really ignite some emotions in you. And the ending, well, I wouldn't say how I feel about it, because then I feel like somehow you will guess. I don't want you to guess. Somehow I really want to talk about it as well, but you will guess it, and that wouldn't be good. So for Manpreet from the future, Manpreet, you just love this book because you always thought this could be the person, and then throughout this book you just realized this couldn't have been that person, and in the end this person is the person you always suspected. So it was just amazing to just, you know, start from suspecting these set of people and then heavily suspecting one person and then realizing this person couldn't have done it, and just go through that entire process. And then, you know, just be in shock on, oh my God, this is it. So that was really fantastic. I really like this book. I feel like if you are into legal thrillers and if you want to read legal thrillers by Indian authors, pick up this book. I really enjoyed it. It is just something you can just flip through during the weekend. So maybe if Amazon delivers to you very quickly, order it now, read it, tell me about it. My Instagram link is down below, my Twitter link is down below. In case you want to gift me any books, you know, or you just want to see my Amazon wishlist, it is also linked down below. And the link to this book is also down below in the description in case you want to purchase with my affiliate link, okay? So, really love this book. Try it out. And that's it for today's reading vlog. I just wanted to make this reading vlog about just one book. I obviously got my hands over other books in this video as well, but I didn't discuss much about it because, yeah, I just wanted to talk about The Mogul, which is a book which I picked up while I was going through a reading slump, and then I just went through it. I just could not put it down. So it's really good. Really liked it. And that's it for today's vlog. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you did, please make sure you give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to me if you're watching me for the first time. Share this video, like this video. And that's it for today's video. This is Manvi signing off. I'll be back with another vlog very soon.